very much. There are 3x5 cards on your chairs, and if you have questions, we also have some pens if any of you need them. And there are two individuals that are walking around the room that would be happy to collect your questions. We have a few already that we can get started with.
I am quite happy in my life. Why should I meditate? Good question. Yes, you are happy in your life, but don't you want to become happier than that? Don't you want to become the happiest in that? Work and you will find that you are a much happier person than what you are now. Why 10 days? Can one learn to meditate in a shorter time? A businessman. I was also a businessman. We always learn how to bargain. We always say, businessman is a busy man. How can I spare 10 days? Oh, impossible for me. When I went to my teacher, the same argument. I'm such a busy person, oh my teacher. You give me the technique, I'll practice at home. I'll practice very seriously. As I practice with you, so I practice at home. Nothing doing. All right, if at all you want me there with you, one day, good enough. I can't spare more. 2 days, 3 days, doesn't work. 100 years back, this technique, for to learn this technique, people have to spare 1.5 months. Otherwise, this technique was not taught. Now, with the fast life, so difficult, nobody will come. Even I would not have gone to my teacher if he said 1.5 months. Not possible. So they decrease it to 1 month. Some result is there. 20 days, some result. 15 days, yes, some result. 10 days, yes, people get the outline of the technique. Good. Something they get. Less than that, nothing. They get frustration. So somebody who spares even 1 day of the life must get some benefit out of it. And it requires 10 days because it's a deep operation of the mind, surgical operation. You go to the depth of the mind, the source of the misery, and you can't go unless you keep on working very continuously and seriously. How does Vipassana help people with depression? Very good question, because the law of nature is such that anything that arises in the mind always arises with a sensation on the body. Law of nature. Anything that arises, good or bad, anything, it will be with a sensation on the body. And this technique will make you able enough to feel the sensations throughout the body, whatever is happening. You are trained for that. And now say depression comes. If you don't know this technique, then the depression will become deeper and deeper. Whatever medicines you take, you are all right for some time, again you are under depression, because the habit pattern is like such. Now this technique, oh, there is depression. At this moment, my mind is full of depression. Not depression due to this or due to that, nothing doing. Depression as depression. And then what sensation I have now? Any sensation that I have in my body at that time is related to this depression. And with the practice of Vipassana, again and again, you are now experienced that every sensation that arises, arises to pass away. It is not eternal. It has to pass away. So let me see. Let me see how long it lasts. It is not eternal. This depression, which is strongly related to this sensation, also not eternal. Let me see how long it lasts. Let me see how long it lasts. It loses its strength, becomes weaker, 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 passes away. You have not suppressed it. You are just observing and it passes away. The habit pattern of generating depression goes away. You are free from it. For this purpose only, we who have got responsibilities, I have found that people with bigger responsibilities, like business executives or government executives, lot of tension in their life. Lot of tension. And many a times, they fall victim to depression. Now, large number of them are coming. The government in India, Maharashtra government, is giving free, 14 days freedom to go and take a Vipassana course of 10 days going and coming 14 days free with salary, because they find it gives so much of help to the officers who are going there and help to the administration. Their capacity to work increases, and then they make good decisions without any tension, with a calm mind, with a clear mind. So all the impurities, any kind of impurities, if you learn how to observe the sensation relating to that, you are coming out of it. Do you still meditate? Certainly. Whatever I preach, I practice. If I don't do that, then I am just a preacher, not a practitioner. It is very essential. It's like exercise. Everyone takes some exercise or the other for the body. You may do jogging or walking or some other physical exercise or yoga to keep your body healthy. So it's a mental exercise. One has to practice every day. You learn 10 days, you go and learn how to do this exercise. Then morning and evening, you do this exercise and you remain very fit and the life is much better. So every day I meditate and I request my students to meditate. How much does retreats cost?
I have a whole stack for you.
Thank you. How much it cost? Can anybody give the cost? It is invaluable. It is priceless. If a price tag is attached to it, then understand there is no purity. We business people, we know how to make money, but don't make money with the technique to which helps others. Give it with love, with compassion, and people should take also in that way. No charges are there. Even no charges for boarding and lodging is the technique where you have to go and stay somewhere. Residential teaching, no charges. Once you start charging something, then always with the mind, oh, now people are coming with so much of, why not I increase the demand, supply? More people are wanting it, so I increase the price. Madness. This is not the way you should serve people with love, with compassion. Then the question comes, how these so many centers are running? Yes, a good question. When people come and take course, there are different types of people coming to the courses, different categories. Some are so poor, especially in India we have seen, poorest of the poor, they come for 10 days. Because they get so much benefit out of it. What one can expect from them for donation? Their 10 days coming there is a donation by itself. So poor, every day they have to work hard to earn money at least to get one meal. And now they have come here. But at the same time, people come from the middle class. People come who are comfortable. At the end of the course, they feel so happy. So peaceful, so joyful. Ah, this wonderful technique must spread. More and more people, miserable, poor or rich, makes no difference. More and more people who are miserable, if they get this technique, they will come out of misery. They will live a better life, good life. Oh, what can I do? I better contribute for the good of others. I have already got it. Somebody donated and because of that, I got this 10 days. I donate now for the good of others. And like this, donation comes, free will, nobody questions. Nobody even knows except one or two people, because those who receive money and give a receipt. Otherwise nobody, otherwise again there will be a comparison. Oh, he has given so much, then how can I give less, I must give more. Or I cannot give this much, he has given so much, one feels depressed, nothing doing. One can give according to one's capacity to give and according to one's volition, that's all. And like this it is going on from last 31 years, and it will continue to go. How does this meditation differ from transcendental meditation? We are not here to compare and contrast. We are not here to condemn any kind of meditation. I know TM very well. The teacher is my good friend. He started it around the world from my house. He stayed with me. I had some friends and I brought him those friends and he started. I am happy. People get benefit, definitely. But then, because I have been practicing similar things in the past and then I got this technique, there is a big difference. When you take some word as a object, although afterwards you leave that word, but that word, repetition of the word, generates a vibration, which is like a shield for you. No bad vibration will come to you. You are happy. But then it becomes a big barrier for you to go to the depth of your mind, where all the moment there is some vibration or the other, good, bad, pleasant, unpleasant, there is something going on, you won't feel that. Because now you've got generated artificial vibration, and you have to work with the natural vibration. That difference is there. Understand, not to condemn any technique, because so many people are getting benefit from it. But those who want to try this, let them try, and they will know the difference. What are three things I can do tomorrow to help make the conversion from misery to happiness? Oh, good. Be happy. You want three things to do? I will say one thing you do. And repeating it twice, three times, make it stronger. One thing. That now I have to spare 10 days of my life. I must go and explore this technique. If it is giving benefit to so many people, why not to me? That itself is good enough. Don't start trying anything. Perhaps trying something you may go on the wrong path, and then to bring it back on the right path will be difficult. Don't do anything. Come with a clean slate as you are, with a determination that I will give 10 days of my life. Good enough. How do you handle difficult people? Yes, good question. Difficult people. You can't run away from difficult people. You can't change the whole world according to your desire, your wishes, your dreams. Not possible. You have to face them. Without this technique, when you face somebody who is performing certain actions which are not only harmful to you, harmful to others, they are difficult people, they won't understand. Then instead of generating anger, hatred, ill will towards them, as you develop in this technique, you will start generating compassion for this person, a miserable person. Whatever he is doing or she is doing, it seems that this action, this wrong action, is harming others. But at the same time, this wrong action is harming this person. This person is generating some defilement on the other to harm others. And every time I know by my experience, I generate defilement, I become miserable, very miserable, burning. How can I throw more petrol on this person? One feels like throwing some cold water. Let him come out of misery, let her come out of misery. That kind of love and compassion, the base changes, the motivation changes. You have to take strong action, you have to take strong action. Because you understand this person does not understand soft language. You try for soft language, doesn't understand. So you have to use soft, hard language, hard vocal action, hard physical action, but deep inside only compassion, compassion. If you generate negativity in you, you become a sick person yourself. You are an unhealthy person yourself. How can you help another unhealthy person? A lame person cannot support another lame person. A blind person cannot guide another person. You have to be healthy yourself, strong yourself, and then you find every action that you take is positive and giving good result. Could you describe how I can best assist business people that are strongly against getting to know getting to know what?
Themselves.
Themselves. Yes, that is the most difficult part. Most difficult thing to do, to know yourself. You know everything in the world by reading books or even by seeing things and all that. You say, I know everything now. I'm the master of knowledge. But you know nothing about yourself, so you know nothing. But once you know about yourself, then it's so easy to know about others also. So easy. You are not trying to know about yourself to satisfy the curiosity, what is with me, who am I, what am I doing, not for that curiosity, not to quench the thirst of your inquisitiveness, what is it, nothing like that. It is just to understand that if there is something wrong in me, I have to change it, to live a better life. So for your own good you are observing it, and observing you find a big change is coming naturally and you are out of your misery. For this purpose one has to know oneself. If we are to become satisfied with our current situation, does that mean we should stop trying to achieve more? Example given, stop trying to make more money. Very good question from the business people. Certainly, I didn't stop that. After taking this course when I was 31 years old, for 14 years I continued my responsibility as a householder, my responsibility as a businessman, as an industrialist. Actually my business and industry flourished much more after Vipassana. It doesn't make one to run away from the responsibility. A big change came, of course. What for I am earning money? What for? Now the happiness is, I am earning, of course, for my own livelihood of those depend on me. But then, whatever extra is with me, I feel like others to share it. There are so many poor people. There are so many ways in which people are miserable. Well, if more and more people get this wonderful technique and they come out of their misery, that feeling starts. So the volition changes. You were giving charity even previously and you give charity now. Volition changes and that gives you inspiration. I earn more so that I can help others more. I am helping only this much. Why don't I help that much? Well, nothing wrong in that. If the volition is to help others without any attachment, and you will find you are such a happy person. Such a happy person. Please describe the technique and how to apply it. Well, just an outline I can give you if you want, but how to apply it and how to understand it, it is necessary to experience it. The whole process is just to experience the truth about yourself, the truth, no imagination, no speculation. So whenever you make a decision to come to a course, you just sit comfortably, as you are sitting now, anywhere, comfortably. Any posture that keeps you comfortable for long periods is a good posture for you. Not necessarily lotus posture or half lotus posture. If someone can sit in that, well and good. Otherwise, any posture, closed eyes, closed mouth, and now what is it? What reality? First reality you experience is the breath coming in, going out, coming in. This is the reality pertaining to your mind, your matter. You start observing it. Of course, difficulties will be there. The mind keeps on wandering. You bring it back to awareness of the respiration. It wanders. You bring it back. Within 2-3 days, you will find the mind is getting settling down. And because you are working on a small area, with the truth, the mind becomes sharper and sharper, subtler and subtler, more and more sensitive. It starts experiencing some biochemical reaction going on here. Some electromagnetic reaction going on here. That means some physical sensation is there. Different kinds of sensations, which are always there throughout the body, every moment. Different kinds of sensations like heat, like perspiration, like cold, like throbbing, pulsing, vibrating, tingling, heaviness. So many things are happening. Now you learn how to observe them objectively. You don't react. Just learn how to observe objectively. If some unpleasant sensation arises, you don't react blindly with aversion. If pleasant sensation arises, don't react blindly with craving. Craving, aversion, you are changing this habit pattern. You are trying to make your mind more and more equanimous. And then in your day-to-day life, in short, this is what you have to do. By 10 days, as much as you change the habit pattern, as much as you are able to observe your sensations on the body, observe the respiration, you will find in your day-to-day life any ups and downs that are coming or any impurity that arisen, maybe fear for the future, always feeling insecure, what will happen to me? I have a lot of money. But if it goes away, what will happen? I've got this status. If this goes away, what will happen? This fear is there. Always feeling insecure. You now start observing the sensation. Whenever fear comes, oh, there is fear. Fear of this or fear of that, doesn't matter. Fear. Let me see what sensation. Let me see what sensation. You are coming out of it. People have come out of it. Anger, hatred, ill will. Now hard criminals in the jails, in the prisons, who have committed murders, so many other heinous crimes. What a change has come. Just within two or three courses, people don't believe. This person, how he's changed? Now in the big centers in India, big jails in India, there are centers, meditation center in the big jail of Delhi, Tihar jail, meditation center in Nasik jail. And I am glad that some courses have started in United States also. And it's starting in different countries. It gives results here and now. Just by this, you are observing and you are changing your habit pattern. Changing your habit pattern. If you are very happy in a good position, you will become happier and happier and happier. If there is something wrong and you are very miserable, you are coming out of it. You are coming out of it. You don't lose anything. Every time one comes and takes a course of 10 days, one does not say, I wasted my 10 days. One does not waste 10 days. Liberation as a concept is intriguing. From what specifically are we being liberated? Liberated from your own habit pattern. When I go and teach these prisoners, I tell them that you are not the only prisoner in the world. All those who are behind the bars, behind the walls, are not the only prisoners. Everyone outside this prison, everyone is a prisoner. Prisoner of one's own unwholesome habit pattern. Deep inside this unwholesome habit pattern. And one is a prisoner. One is a slave. One cannot come out of it. And keeps on suffering, suffering, suffering. So this technique helps people who are in the jail, prison, and also who are in prison outside. So it works for everybody. So liberation is from the unwholesome habit pattern. Change it to wholesome habit pattern, you are a happier person. Equanimous sounds good, but doesn't enthusiasm and passion help a person to do amazing things? Yes. When you learn equanimity, this does not mean that you are now indifferent. I don't care whether I get money or not money, I don't care. And I don't care in my family if somebody is sick, what, I am a Vipassana meditator. Now I don't care, I am equanimous. No, no. Equanimity means your mind does not have any kind of habit of blind reaction. Action is always there. You are coming out of blind reaction. Whenever there is a blind reaction, either of craving or of aversion or anything, blind reaction, there is an element of negativity in it. You generate negativity, you generate misery for yourself, you make others miserable. But when the mind is equanimous, positive. And that becomes action. Action is always positive. Good for you and good for others. You won't become inactive. Don't worry. And you keep on progressing. Does not our dissatisfaction, our unhappiness with our lives at times attribute to the success we experience? Without such unhappiness, could our success have been achieved? What you call success? Success in the material wealth, yes. But is it a real success when your misery has increased? When you don't know how to keep your mind really happy, really peaceful? No, no success. So be wealthy in the material world, perfectly all right, nothing wrong. But be wealthy inside in your mind also, all the time happy, peaceful, all the time full of love, compassion for others. You are happy to earn money. At the same time, you are happy that you are making best use of the money for the good of others also, along with your own good. A comment, I think, if more people developed the self-awareness and decreased activity, that might lead to not only individual about the society and the world. No, no, no. Just was the same answer. You don't become inactive. I have seen with my own experience. I become so more active. It's not just by vipassana I become like a vegetable, let anybody come and cut me, I don't care, I am vipassana meditator. Nothing doing. Nothing doing. People who keep on giving their experience, of course my own experience after taking courses, my capacity increased so much to work. But now I find thousands of people who keep on writing me, this technique has helped me to increase my capacity to work, to increase my capacity. Otherwise why governments and business people, they send their chief executives to come to the courses? Because they find it gives better results, more results. Don't be afraid. You will get better results, better income, better profits, but along with that, the best profit of living a peaceful life, happy life, harmonious life. May all of you experience real peace, real harmony, real happiness within yourself, and be an example for the others to live a happy life, peaceful life, harmonious life. Thank you.